Guys, y'all already know what's about to happen. It is time to hit myself with the depression, and for you guys, the secondhand depression. And so today we're gonna be rolling on Palomar's banner as well as the Nikki banner. Me personally, I actually need both Nikki and Oddy, so this is a great banner for me. No more talking, only slamming. I'm only gonna go for like the one by ones for the guaranteed 5-star. I really, really want the Nikki, but like to be honest, hello Chainsaw Rick. I don't know about you guys, but ever since this rotating recruitment has hit like the rotating every single week, I'm kind of like coming up short in terms of the yellow star flares. I don't know how you guys are keeping up, but like that's actually quite a lot of star flares to burn through every single week, right? So if we're going like 10 a week, that's 40 star flares a month. All right, I believe this is number 4. We got a blue, we got Leah. Thank you. Number 5, come on, just give me the Oddy or give me the Nikki. That's okay. Patty and Patsy it is. Next one, number 6, I believe. I think it's my 6th roll. It's another blue. Man, what are these rates, boys? What are these rates? Give me the Fat Juicer. That is a 5-star. All right, that's it. Give me the Oddy. Please give me the Oddy. That is Oddy. Woo! That's what I'm talking about. I cannot be mad about this. Oddy is just so freaking strong, especially for like your end game in Elysium and stuff like that. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and skip that and then let's go and roll on the big juicer, the one that we really care about. Okay, Paloma, you had better come home. Please, big pray. All right, I'm gonna hit confirm and let's go. Okay, guaranteed 5-star. You know, I can't just have a 6-star straight up, you know what I'm saying? And then we got a 1 5-star. Holy crap, what is this 5-star rate? This looks new. So, oh, we got Naraxel, which is the new 5-star. That's nice. And she's pretty cool. Her art is actually a little bit different, in my opinion, to a lot of the other art. It's not that it's inconsistent, but this is kind of like has a different style. Anyway, moving on, let's go for the 20 rolls. Big prey, big prey. All right, 20 rolls for Paloma. Come on, Paloma. Just come home, please. Please. Let's go. Let's see what we... Oh my god, are you serious? It's a freaking purple bag. Holy moly. I don't know where this is gonna go. Actually, you know what? I do know where this is going. And I don't want to go there, man. I don't want to go there, my guys. And so this is 30. Come on. 30. Give it to me. Give me something good. Don't give me another purple bag. Come on. That's a 5-star. All right. Skip. That is nothing new. It is what it is. Let's put it that way. It is what it is. All right, and I've got 20 pulls left. We're gonna go 40 over here. Come on, Paloma. Please. Another 5-star? Seriously? I'm gonna have to go to Pity again. And it's not even a new one either. So we've got Naraxel, we've got Barbara. It's kind of meh. I don't know about this one, guys. And so with this, we should be hitting Pity. 3.3k. Let's go the 10 times. Come on. What is this luck, man? This luck is so crap. All right, last one. Come on. Oh, is that the 6? I think that's the 6. Okay. Oh, that's the 6. Okay, big prey, guys. Big prey. That's not her, is it? Oh my god, what the frick? Guys, I am so freaking done with this game. Like, holy crap. Come on. I can't, guys. What the Seriously, Tour Dog, if you're out there watching this suffering, I don't even have anything to say to you guys, man. This freaking game, although I still think it's the best one that has been released this year, it's just so infuriating. Like, holy crap. Like, seriously? Ugh. Jesus. And so guys, I guess there we have it. We have a freaking Gronru dupe. Let's look at the bright side. Hi, welcome back to another Alchemy Stars video. My name is Lace and I want to do a lot of bad things to myself. Today, let's have a look at the event, but not just that. I'm actually really curious to talk about like the competitive mode, the new one. And so I can't remember what it's called, but it's called like CC as well. I don't know what that was inspired by. Ah, there it was, Calamity Codex. So this one over here. But before we go into Calamity Codex, let's have a look at Letter from the Skies, which is our new event involving Erevale, which is pretty cool. So this event is pretty straightforward. It's quite similar to, I believe, like the hero event, but essentially we're gonna be spending stamina on whatever we want. We're gonna be getting these 540 currencies, as you can see over here. I believe these are called Union Snacks. And then with these Union Snacks, we are gonna be rebuilding Erevale. So we've got this over over here. And so as you can see, I actually cleaned up the wall. So let me clean the wall lamp here. And so I have to spend 150 of these union snacks to clean it up. And so, ooh, look at that. It looks nice. And then so on top of that, you've got these like little minor events down here with the exclamation marks. And so if I click on one of them, poof. There we go. And then we are rewarded for these small tasks. So I'm going to get rid of the spider web. I just yeeted that spider away. Whoops. But otherwise, it's pretty straightforward. So we're going to be farming for these snacks. And then we're just going to be cleaning up the place. And then when we finally hit some milestones, we can actually claim some Lumamba as well as some other goodies. A lot of Lumamba to be had. Like if I go through all of this, wow, wait, holy crap. There's 10 pages of this, which is pretty good. But yeah, aside from that, like it's pretty standard. There's not too much to say about this. And so with that, let's go back and have a look at the event itself. This is like I think one of the zero cost stamina events. And so that's really nice. If I click into this, yeah, it's just like a whole bunch of Lumamba. All right, and then coming out of that, we got the Aurorian Trials. So we got god. Why Tour Dog? Why are you the way you are, Tour Dog? Seriously. You know what? Let's give her a shot. It's not like I'll be able to use her anytime soon anyway. So there we have it, Paloma. Look at her. She is so freaking cute. Oh my god. And so she is a global sniper, very similar to Fleur's archetype. So if you get enough cells, then you can hit everyone on the map. That's pretty much it. That's for her chain combo. However, this one is really interesting, actually. So what I do is I place a tile and then I place a direction in which I want it to spawn. And so as you can see, this is actually going to hit a whole bunch of mobs. So let's initiate that and see where this goes. So it's going to come up here and it's just going to go everywhere. What the frick? Yeah, look, guys, like I knew what it did. That actually just shocked me a little bit. I didn't realize that the effects were going to be that crazy, but alas, it is what it is. It was cool. It was really cool. I just wish I had her, you know, Tour Dog. Like, frick my luck, man. Why is my luck so trash? Anyway, guys, aside from that, it's pretty much the same, like a pretty sick sniper. She's going to be doing a lot of damage. You can see the single target damage is actually quite high, 9.4k, 10k, 10k, 10.1k, 11k. Okay, wait, that's actually a lot of damage. And then 20k. On the chain combo. But yeah, Paloma unfortunately is competing against Midgard, who has been a very big staple in terms of like the forest teams. She's got a teleport, she's got like a little bit of AoE damage, and she's got like some sort of some level of execution. And so it'll be really interesting to see how Paloma actually stacks up against Midgard, because like I'm pretty interested to see. Me personally, I want to run Paloma instead because like she's so freaking cute, but like oh my god. And so I'm not going to bore you with the rest of the stage. And so let's move on to have a look at the new game mode, CC, Calamity Codex. Okay, guys, so welcome to Calamity Codex. I must say, I'm not a massive fan of this font choice over here. I think that the designers could make some improvements to that, to say the least. But you know what? They can do whatever they want. And if this is what the customers want, then so be it. And so as you can see, we have Nefarious Ferozion. So the idea of this game mode is essentially like a boss battle. You go in, you have about like 10 turns to do as much damage as you possibly can. And then the amount of damage you do will be converted into a score in which you'll be ranked against it. So as you can see, we have bronze all the way up to legendary. And so let's talk about this one first. And I think it's quite good because I don't see any exclusive items, which is really nice. And on top of that, it's actually quite a healthy amount of Lumamba, even if you just get up to like platinum, for example. And it's not actually competitive at all until you get to legendary. And so what I mean by that is that everybody could technically get Paragon if you are strong enough. And for the whales or the guys who want to go a step further, the real hardcore players, yes, they are getting more ranked rewards, but it is kind of like not as significant, right? I would say that they are getting like what, like maybe 10% more than like what everyone could be getting if we all hit Paragon. And so in my opinion, I think this reward structure is what's fantastic. It's essentially everything I wanted in like a ranked system, if it was possible. I don't know about you guys, but I generally don't like ranked systems because like you have to climb over each other to get a certain rank and rewards. But in this one, everyone can achieve up to Paragon, and like legendary is just for like the real hardcore players who want to battle it out. And so to this game mode, I'm going to say to Tour Dog, well done. Well, the reward structure at least. And so moving back to the game mode itself. So as you can see, we have a team over here. And I think a very natural guess would be that each of these teams are going to face off a different element boss. And so what that means is that hopefully your mono element teams, like for all four elements, have been coming along, and hopefully they will do some work for you. And like, I want to point out this guy over here, because Aurorian element counter damage plus 100%. That's essentially doubling your damage if you are using like the counter element. And so whilst you could do some mix and match, I would say that you should be on the counter element for every single boss. On top of that, let me click into this and see. Okay, it's not showing the buffs, but I believe that the dots are not going to be working in this game mode. What I mean by dots, I'm talking about burn, I'm talking about poison, I'm talking about bleed. And I've shown you guys in a previous video how broken they can be. But if I'm not wrong, your Uriel, your Leona, your bleeders, like your burners, they're all going to be benched for this one as well. And to be honest, I'm not sure how I feel about that, because like, why would you make units like Oddy and all of these like poisonous dotters, why would you make them obsolete? I just think it's really sad because it invites like a whole new playstyle, right? And so for this event itself, I would say it's probably looking like your same comp. So for like for this guy over here, if this guy is Thunder, then you're going to be using your Forest team. And I would say it's probably going to be like your Araya, it's going to be your Pact, it's going to be your Sicare, Midgard, Luis, and so forth, probably your Hero as well. I feel like Tour Dog making all of these bosses immune to dots is kind of boring. The fact that we're pretty much going to be just running the same power team over and over, like this, you could argue that this is like a burst team, but it's not really. Especially if the rounds are going to go up to 10, like you can just do your bursts like 3 or 4 times, right? I reckon Tour Dog should just let the people who have the dot units built use them. Like for your water, it's probably going to be the Regal or like the Sharona, it's going to be the Sariel. You could take the Filishai, but you're trying to do as much damage as possible, and so you're probably going to try to get away with as much like passive healing as you can. And so what I mean by that is it's probably looking like your Icy or like your Victoria. I don't know about your Connolly. Raphael is a strong maybe, especially because Raphael does damage but also provides pseudo healing. And then it's almost certainly your Barton is probably going to be your Klecken. I don't think I have any of those units, which is really, really freaking sad. Stacking as much power damage as you can with like possibly some side healing. So in terms of Forest, we do have Luis who does heal on a full 15 chain combo. And then coming over to Fire, I'm going to say that Cinsa is probably your usual suspect for like raising your damage again. It's just times like this, especially when they don't block like the vulnerability, but they do block the dots. Cinsa is just going to thrive over and over and over again in all sorts of content. But otherwise, the other characters you're looking at are probably like Charon, Faust, Icy. And then depending on whether it's like a single tile boss or a multi-tile boss, you're going to be looking at your detonators versus snipers, but like generally detonators still are going to be supreme. So you're probably going to be looking at your Victoria. I'm not sure about Uriel. Leona will probably sit out. Isvan is probably going to go in. Nails will probably sit out and Maggie will probably go in if you have a high enough breakthrough. In my opinion, the cross converters really have a lot more value when they get their breakthrough, which enables their, what is it called? This guy over here, the preemptive strike, because essentially what it means is that you've just gained an extra massive burst, right? And so where you would only previously be able to get like 4 bursts off, maybe you can now get 5 with a preemptive cross converter. Funnily enough, I don't have a single preemptive cross converter, which really sucks. But those of you who do have it, I suspect they're just going to be so strong in this game mode, and probably literally every other game mode as well. And so just taking a look at Thunder, so I did see something that was pretty interesting, and it's that the boss may negate percentage HP damage. And so what that means is that they've utterly cucked Michael and like Schwartz, and so they've lost their appeal, but like I would still say that they are pretty freaking strong, especially just because of their archetype, right? Like Michael's detonator, he does like the teleports, he does like the big damage, but otherwise, let's go through it. We're probably looking at a Revy. It's got 10 rounds. And so Revy will be able to stack quite a fair bit, which is good. You're probably looking at Gronru. I don't know about Iridin. Probably not Nadine. Probably Michael. Beverly's almost certainly in. And then we've got Schwartz. I would say Schwartz is probably still going to be pretty strong, even if they did like nerf that HP percentage damage. I reckon Mythos, I reckon Requiem, like those two old seal characters are also going to be really strong here. Otherwise, that's kind of my thoughts on like who is going to be strong in this game mode. And to be honest, it's not rocket science, right? Because they utterly gutted one archetype, like the dot archetype. And so really the only other way to play is to like play normally, which is to convert and then slam them as hard as you can, which is kind of getting stale. I just want to make something bleed, you know? Like, oh my god. Anyway, guys, I think that's kind of it for this video. There's not overly much to talk about for this one. To summarize my thoughts on Calamity Codex, I really do like what I'm seeing. I'm just hoping that it's not going to end up being a massive chore like Secret Territory is. And the thing about this is that as they add more of these game modes potentially for like every single week, we're going to start getting bloated with content, right? Like, I don't know how many of you are still going on with Secret Territory, but if they keep adding like more and more weeklies, it's going to be a lot to manage. And so I'm really hoping that they'll go back and put in like an auto mode for the secret territory. But you know what? I'm not a pro games designer, so Tour Dog, I'm sure you guys have it in the bag. And so with that, let me ask you guys, how do you guys feel about Calamity Codex? And if you guys have not caught on yet, that is our first secret question, because this next secret question is gonna be about, you guessed it, it is about Mommy over here. Did you guys roll for Paloma? Did you guys get her? Did you guys have good luck or bad luck? Did you guys win your 50-50? I'm gonna be honest, guys, every time I lose a 50-50, my love for the game is like, and I'm like, here, my guys, like, I'm like, okay, I don't actually know what that means, but anyway, you guys let me know how you guys went and how you guys feel about the event in the comments below. And I would really appreciate that, because it means you've watched up until the end of the video, and so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a like, a sub, a follow, and if you would like to support the channel, we do have some things down in the description below. But otherwise, as Paloma once said, not to me, because she didn't come home, but she did say that all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.